Bill Stenross here with TUF News. I'm here with Coach Manny Lagos after a hard-fought 0-0 draw down here in Tampa Bay. Manny, can you give us your initial impressions of this game tonight?
You know, at the end of the day, we're at Al Lang Stadium playing against Tampa Bay, and it was a very hard-fought draw. There was a lot of movement in the game, and a lot of things to improve for next week, and we'll work on improving them.
So what specifically are you looking at improving next week?
You know, at the end of the day, the players went out there today from Minnesota and played a game, and we came out with a draw, and you know, there are some things that next week we will go back to Minnesota and train because we're playing soccer and improve.
Okay. Can you just give us something more? What specifically? Midfield, defense, attack? What are you improving in?
You know, we played the game of soccer. It's played for 90 minutes between two teams, and there are goals scored. There weren't any goals scored today, and hopefully we'll be scoring some goals this week. And at the end of the day, the players score goals, and we'll be trying to make them score goals.
Well, Manny, it's always a pleasure, I guess, to talk to you. Thank you for giving us so much to work with. Bill Stenross with TUF News. Bill Stenross here again with TUF News. I'm here tonight with Thomas Rangan. It was a tough-fought game against Minnesota United. You came away with 1 point in the 0-0 draw. What are your initial impressions of the game?
Sorry, Bill. Just finishing up one more tweet here. Emoji thumbs up, emoji thumbs up, emoji thumbs up. Sorry, Bill. 0-0 draw. We were very sad to come away with that. We played the game for the fans, and to have that kind of result was disappointing.
I know you probably weren't happy with how the team was playing in the first half. Could you tell us what you told them in halftime to get them to kind of change the game?
We came out really defensively in the first half and respected Minnesota United's offensive capabilities. We were playing three defensive mids in the first half to come out. The second half, we decided that it was really time to play a little more offensive-minded game, Bill. So we brought in Martin Nunez. Good player. He always plays for the fans, and you know, we really were just hoping to put on a good show for the fans and really make them happy. And it reminds me a lot of my childhood and the mistakes that I've made in the past, and have all led me here to this point here today. So I put a lot of the blame on myself for what I've done. I like to think that I see a little bit of my adolescent self in our goalkeeper here today, and I just wish I could have done better back then in the day. So young, and I never saw her again. And that's why I wear the bow tie. Thank you, Bill.
Thank you, Coach Rangan. I really appreciate that very in-depth response to my two questions.
Hello, my friend Manny. What would you like to eat today?
You know, I've been thinking about restaurants and food, and I'm undecided, and you know, we're in Tampa right now, and I think maybe at the end of the day, you're the one who should make this decision.
Well, thank you, my friend. I know this morning, whistling through the trees on the warm breeze, I felt a slight tingle in my back, and it reminded me of the saffron cooking my mother used to make in my childhood, and I just want to do it for my mother and have some Indian cooking today. Is that okay with you, my friend?
You know, at the end of the day, restaurants serve food, and it's always good to eat that food, and you know, it all comes out the same later, and you know, really for the players, it's good for me to stay healthy, and at the end of the day, all I want to do is just go there and finish well, you know, and it'll be good.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Two United Fans. My name is Kyle.
And I'm Notch, and we got a great episode for you today. Bill Stenross joined us to talk about Tampa Bay versus Minnesota United, the Loons' season opener.
Woo! The season is upon us.
Mm-hmm.
And yesterday we released another episode of TUF Cast, so if you haven't had a chance to take a listen to that, go check it out.
Yeah, find it on iTunes, Stitcher, and our blog as well. Also wanted to mention, if you haven't looked at your mail recently, Minnesota United sent out their season tickets. Very cool stuff. Black on black, it's the coolest color. Tom Haverford says that on Parks and Rec. But anyway, also want to just take a moment to acknowledge Mike Bowers, who's standing right behind the camera right now and helping us out again. Mike's done a bunch of camera work for us in our intro, that beautiful shot of the players running up to the camera. That was Mike's work, so we're really happy to have him join us. But we're going to take a quick break and come back with Bill.
You're watching Two United Fans.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Two United Fans. Sitting with me now is frequent contributor to our show, Northern Pitches, Bill Stenross, who had the chance to go to the renovated Al Lang Stadium this past weekend. How was that?
It was fantastic. I had a blast down there. It didn't hurt that it was 86 degrees and sunny the entire weekend, but it was fantastic. Tampa Bay has done an amazing job upgrading their facility. Mm-hmm. It still feels like that minor league baseball stadium when you're walking the concourse, but when you get out on the pitch, you can sense that this is a soccer stadium now. It's not a baseball stadium. Mm-hmm. The pitch is looking great. There's still a little bit of waviness and problems, but around the stands are fantastic. It's totally branded Rowdies. You see green and gold everywhere, the logos everywhere. They've got this phrase that they put on a lot of their stuff that we stand for soccer. It's really cool.
Is Tampa Bay like an FC or SC? Do you know?
I think it's just Tampa Bay Rowdies.
Okay,
it's
that's old good. School. It's so they're not school. Minnesota United FC. We are soccer.
Yes.
It's okay. So that's good. So there's no contradiction.
There's no contradiction there. The fans I met were uniformly great. Yeah. Probably my favorite one that I met was this 70-year-old Republican granny holding a beer. she was maybe 4 feet 6 inches, but she was just fantastic. The tailgating was great. I got to go to the Rowdy's Den, their new themed bar. I wish we had something like that here for Minnesota, a place where you knew that it was just soccer. This is the soccer place. So it was such a great place to go and watch a game. The press box was actually outside.
That's cool. There you go. I saw your photos. And by the way, I know you had a good time because I saw you hanging out with Jason, our former editor, who is the best guy in the world.
Oh, man. Jason was so nice. Really helped me out, actually set me up with a place to stay. And just showed me around, introduced me to all the people. It was really great.
That's terrific. So let's start talking a little bit about the game. As much as I want to keep talking about the stadium, we should talk about the game a little bit. Overall thoughts, what did you think?
Oh, at the 90th minute, I was disappointed. You know, you wanted to see Minnesota win their first game, get 3 points on the road would have been fantastic. But overall, I think it was a pretty good performance, a pretty good result for Minnesota.
What did you see happening on the pitch as you watched those 90 minutes?
You know, the first half was fantastic. You saw the team just move around, switch positions. Steele and Mendez in particular were given a lot of freedom to switch sides. You saw Steele on the left primarily, then he moved over to the right and then back to the left. In the midfield also with Barr and Ibsen, I saw them getting a lot of space to move around. Tampa Bay and Coach Rollingen after the game talked about this, came out with a very conservative game plan. They put two holding midfielders in their back line of four, and their goal was to prevent Minnesota from having any chances, and they did. Other than that first chance in the first 5 minutes, they really struggled to create a lot of chances.
That's when Steele hit the post. We'll talk about that in just a second. I want to ask you about how he did and Ibsen did. But first, let's talk about Miguel Ibarra and Christian Ramirez. You know, our big stars, the people everyone's been asking questions about, all the newcomers are like, Miguel and Christian, are they going to be in MLS? Well, let's talk about how they did in their first game back. Ibarra had that one chance that he set up for Ramirez when he got the ball off Chantafowski, the goalkeeper. Talk about that one and tell me how they did.
You know, they didn't do this a lot, but occasionally they would press and bring a lot of players forward to try and get the ball back. And that one time, that it worked. The goalkeeper got a little scared. Ibarra was able to get the ball, but Ramirez unfortunately wasn't able to get it just over the arms of the goalkeeper, Tampa Bay's goalkeeper. But at the same time, Ibarra, well, he had a typical game for Ibarra. He was all over the field. He was involved in a lot of the play. He was involved in a lot of the buildup. Ramirez kind of got lost, and I could understand it. You know, seeing how Tampa Bay played, they played with four in the back and then two just in front of the back. So Ramirez was dealing with a lot of people on him for most of the time. You saw Minnesota try and chip it over to Ramirez, and it worked that one time with a long ball that Ramirez was able to run with for a bit and pass to Johnny Steele. and that was the only shot on goal for Minnesota. But overall, he did get a little lost, and I think people were a little, justifiably a little bit frustrated, because Ramirez, we've kind of come to see him as that, he's going to create chances, he's going to get chances, and he just didn't really have many this game.
So, very briefly, the decision to put Campos on for Ramirez when the score was still 0-0, do you think that was a good idea? Did it work?
I think at that time, Manny Lagos was saying, okay, this is going to be a 0-0 draw. We're willing to... I want to get Campos more game minutes in a real game, get him out there, but we're not necessarily going all out now to try and get the 3 points, which was fair. They were struggling by that point as Tampa Bay had kind of figured out how to unlock their midfield and their defense and was threatening frequently.
Okay, well, let's talk about now how Johnny Steele and Ibsen did. You know, we were expecting both of them to play in the formation, this new starting lineup that we've come to this year. What's your evaluation of those two boys?
Johnny Steele, you know, he was my man of the match. I thought he was the best player. Mm-hmm. Not necessarily, I didn't think anybody truly stood out, but I thought he brought something that we haven't seen from anybody other than Miguel Ibarra, and that's an awareness of where he's on the field, where to find space, where to move. He had a couple of just almost there through balls to a couple players. They were just a level above what we've seen in NASL a lot of times. That he tried to thread through and just didn't get through.
And he had the shot where it hit the post.
Yeah. I mean, that was fantastic awareness on his part. You know, he was on the right side somehow. After Minnesota got the ball back and made a great run staying onside, and Ramirez got him the ball, and you know what, honestly, it was a great shot, and the goalkeeper made a really good save.
So the one thing, I mean, I mentioned this yesterday on TUFcast, our audio podcast, which is that I thought Ibsen didn't impress me, and you can go listen to TUFcast for why. I don't want to bore you with that, Bill, because I know that you think Ibsen did pretty well.
Well, I mean, I don't think he had the best game ever, but I think he did a great job of controlling that midfield. Part of that was the way that Minnesota set up, and sometimes they would have 3-4 players even with or near even with the back line, and that just gave Ibsen so much room to carry the ball up. What I would have liked to see from Ibsen and from Ibarra, and somewhat from Steele and Mendes, is them actually carrying it and beating a player on the dribble. I really felt like there was space in the middle to work with, and they kept going for these passes out wide that would lead to these crosses that were not high percentage chances on goal. And in fact, didn't lead to any decent shot on goal in the entire game.
Yeah, so let's talk also a little bit about what you spoke to Thomas Rongen about after the game. You said that he kind of opened up to you a little bit about what his plan was.
Absolutely. Thomas Rongen was a fantastic coach to interview. He was very open. Felt like he, in the first half, kind of set up the Rowdies with tactically incorrectly. He knew that Minnesota was a very talented offensive team, and so brought in two holding midfielders as opposed to one. Minnesota spent most of the game with only one holding midfielder, Pitch Colin. And Pitch Colin's job, it seemed like, was to mark Hristov, who didn't have a great game, honestly. Didn't have a lot of chances on goal. But for to hear Rongen say that, and he talked about that midfield triangle, and wondering maybe if he had switched it around, if he had put just one holding midfielder and two central midfielders, that would have been really great for Tampa Bay going forward. I wonder, though, would that have opened it up more? Would Minnesota have had that space to come forward and attack through the middle instead of what they tried to do, which was maintain possession, move it outside, cross in, and then hope to get a good look on goal or a corner?
It was, you know, somewhat surprising, the two of these teams that are so, since, you know, Tampa's win last week, they've been hyped a lot. Minnesota has, you know, been naturally getting a lot of hype since the preseason. They made all these big moves, and their performance last year, of course. It was a little surprising to see these two hype teams go and play a 0-0 draw. You know, all the predictions on Twitter were, it's going to be an explosion. You know, we predicted a lot of high-profile stuff. So what's your kind of in leaving this game, now that you're a few days after it, walking away, where do you think it was?
Well, I think one thing that it shows is that both Tampa Bay and Minnesota, although I'm still not entirely convinced with the defense, they're better. They're solid defenses. They're good defenses. I mean, this was a 0-0 draw with two teams with some very strong offensive threats. Mm-hmm. And, you know, although Tampa Bay had more chances towards the end of the game, Minnesota was able to weather them and survive and get the point on the road. I was expecting it to be a 3-3 draw. You know, ultimately, it doesn't really matter. It's the same result.
Yeah.
1 point for both teams. But, you know, I think it shows how much Tampa Bay has changed since last year. You know, getting the new coach wrong and getting 20 new players mm-hmm. on their roster. It's really made that team a new team. And one to watch out for in the NASL this season.
Absolutely. I'll be watching some more of their games. But let's not forget what the most important takeaway from this weekend was. The Cosmos drew their game. So anyway, that's all we have time for right now. We're going to take a quick break, and then Kyle and I will take you out of today's episode right now.
Thank you very much for watching another episode of Two United Fans. We're glad to have you here.
Absolutely. Now, make sure you subscribe on YouTube, you like us on Facebook, what's it called on Twitter? I think it's called follow. You should follow us on Twitter. You should find us on services that we're not on, like Instagram, too. Read our blog on Northern Pitch. Sometimes we write stuff, too. Mm-hmm. And finally,
listen to us. If you're tired of looking at these faces, you can stare at a blank screen and still hear our beautiful voices with TUF Cast. This is a weekly audio pod we're putting out. Check us out on iTunes, Stitcher, SoundCloud, and something else that we automatically upload to. We are everywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks again. See you later.
Goodbye.
Well, Bill, we came out and we started playing very defensively. I thought our defensive mids really didn't step up in the formation that I had played him in. Wasn't that great, you know? So I really thought there was a few things differently that I would like to do, and starting with the player formations that I started working up back in January. And, you know, that stemmed a lot from my past childhood memories that I think I've made some mistakes back in the day, you know? That still haunts me today. So God damn it.